There are two major options for IMGs to practice in Canada. Number one is a province-based specialist with hospital-specific license. Option two is the Royal College Certified Specialist. If you're an international medical graduate who has done specialization training or residency in your home country and now planning to move to Canada, I will tell you how you can be a specialist doctor in Canada without doing any residency. Make sure you watch till the end so you learn from all my years of experience in just less than 30 minutes. If you're new here, I'm Dr. Rajiv Iyer, an associate professor of anesthesiology at University of Pennsylvania in the USA. The first eligibility criteria is that your medical training must be recognized by the World Health Organization. You can check your medical college very easily from this link you see on the screen, and I've also left this in the description below. There are two major options for IMGs to practice in Canada. Number one is a province-based specialist with hospital-specific license. In the province of Ontario, this is based on postgraduate education certificate that the College of Physicians and Surgeons of Ontario provides. This is an option for IMGs from low to middle income countries like India, China, Brazil, Pakistan, Bangladesh, etc. I will explain this more in detail. If you're watching this video, I'm going to assume you're more likely to be in this category. Option two is the Royal College Certified Specialist. The Royal College of Physicians and Surgeons in Canada provides three options for IMGs. Number one is approved jurisdiction. Number two is practice eligibility route. Number three is subspecialty examination affiliate program, abbreviated as SEAP. It is important you understand all these here. Whether you go through the province-based pathway or the Royal College pathway, irrespective of this, a license to practice medicine is required, and this is issued by the state medical boards, which in Canada is regulated by different provinces. For example, College of Physicians and Surgeons in Ontario. First of all, I'm going to tell you about the province-based specialist with a hospital-specific license. Coming from India myself, I have come across many IMGs who have been successful through this alternate entry path program using the postgraduate education certificate. The selection into this is based on a bit of luck and the time you're in Canada and the specific needs of individual hospital. I'll show you a specific example of someone in this pathway so you get a first-hand experience of how this process works. Now, this you're seeing on the screen is a screenshot from the College of Physicians and Surgeons of Ontario. I have used Ontario as an example since I used to live in Ontario, and I have seen this happen firsthand in front of me. This candidate has entered Canada in 2013 and has done multiple fellowships. In 2016, this candidate received a postgraduate education certificate. This means this candidate is now working as an assistant professor with a restricted license. Here is what you see. The language is specifically written to limit this person from working in only one hospital. Now, this candidate will have 7 years to prove academic excellence as set forth by the hospital where this person is working. In this case, the certificate of registration expires in 2023. After this, they're promoted to associate professor from an assistant professor. Then the restriction on the license is taken off. This means this candidate is now free to move to other hospitals or provinces if they wish to. I know quite a few people who have been successful using this route. This candidate got the postgraduate education certificate relatively soon, in approximately 3 years. But there are others whom I know who have required close to 5 years just to get into this pathway and then start the 7-year clock. Once the specialist graduates to an associate professor, their status on the college website will be turned to active. You can check the status of any doctor in Ontario, whether they are practicing now or whether they have stopped practicing, by using this link that you see on the screen and is also in the description below. Specifically, if you're wondering how you can do this for yourself and be successful, The first step is you have to get into Canada as a fellow. This could be a clinical fellow or a research fellow. I have been candidates being successful in both these ways. Post in the comments below if you have any questions. Reach out to me either on my YouTube channel or Instagram on Anesthesia Guru by clicking the attached links in the description below. All right, that is about the college-specific restricted license pathway. Now, how about the Royal College approved training pathways? First of all, let's look at the approved jurisdiction route. Oh, by the way, post in the comments below what country you're from. The Royal College of Physicians and Surgeons of Canada has approved a few countries outside Canada and the USA where the training is similar to Canada. If you're a physician trained from one of the below country, then you can apply to the Royal College for your training assessment. Once the college formally approves your application, you will be given eligibility to write the final certifying exam. You will have 5 years to complete this exam once the Royal College approves your application. In my experience, physicians I have known have completed this pathway in just a year or so. And these are those people who have come from India, have had some training in the UK, and are now successful in Canada. But this can be anyone from any country. Once you clear this exam, you'll be a fellow of the Royal College, and you're going to either receive an FRCPC, which stands for Fellow of the Royal College of Physicians of Canada, or FRCSC, which is the Fellow of the Royal College of Surgeons of Canada, based on your specialization. Here is the list of countries under approved jurisdiction. Australia and New Zealand, Hong Kong, Singapore, South Africa, Switzerland, UK and Ireland. Here where this gets very confusing. The requirements for each specialty and each province is different. I encourage you check the most recent requirements on the Royal College website that you see on the screen and is also left in the description below. The next Royal College approved pathway is the practice eligibility route. If you are an international physician already working in Canada, then you should investigate this option. I am not sure what country training is eligible for this pathway because I couldn't find this on the Royal College website. While I was preparing for this video, I actually wrote an email to the Royal College. I'm yet to hear back from them. As soon as I get an answer, I'm going to post this in the comments below. There are two things that happen with this pathway. Number one is your training should get evaluated. The time in training of your specialization should be equal to Royal College training equivalent. This depends on the specialty, and for anesthesiology, the training requirements is 5 years. I have used anesthesiology as an example, and you can check your specialty requirements from this link that you see on the screen and in the description below. The second thing that needs to happen is evaluation of your practice or your clinical work. This pathway is available only for primary specialties, but not for subspecialty training. For example, if you're an anesthesiology trained candidate, then you can be FRCPC in anesthesiology, but not in pediatric anesthesiology, cardiac anesthesiology, obstetric anesthesiology, etc. Here are the major steps to apply for the practice eligibility route. The first step, as I mentioned, is your training document evaluation. For this, you apply to the Royal College. This should be done at the website that you see on the screen, and I've left it in the description below. The reason for leaving it in the description below is just to make it easy for you to access it anytime. You create an account on the Physicians Apply website. Then you pay a non-refundable fees. There is many different fee structure, and you can check this link for the most latest information. Submit the following documents for source verification. There may be additional requirements, but these are basic things. Your medical school or your medical college degree or diploma. Your medical degree transcript. Now, transcript is a document that many medical schools or colleges do not provide. For people trained in India, like me, we don't typically require a medical school transcript unless we specifically request for this. This is a very easy process. There was a formal application that I had to make to my medical college, and they were able to give it to me in a very short span of time. This might be the same case for you. Your internship certificate, your postgraduate or your specialty certificate training, your medical license or your registration, outside Canada, and your medical license or registration certificate. After everything is source verified, you pass the Medical Council of Canada qualifying examination, also called as MCCQE Part 1. There are some specific recommended study materials for this that you can check out in the link below in the description. The next major step is you take the Royal College exam. Once everything is through, you're going to receive eligibility for writing the Royal College exam, and you will again have 5 years to complete this exam. The exam will have two parts, a written part and an applied part. The format is similar in the USA as well. Both should be completed within the 5 year period that the Royal College gives you. This exam is taken at a Royal College center in Canada. At the time I'm recording this video, there is one last step in the practice eligibility route. Your practice time in Canada needs to get assessed. Here, you must complete 2 to 5 years of clinical work in Canada, and then you apply to Royal College for assessment of practice time. Out of these 5 years, a minimum of 2 years must be in Canada to become certified. All right, so now you have completed your training assessment, your Royal College exam, your practice assessment, and now you pass your exams. Voila, congratulations. You are now board certified by the Royal College of Physicians and Surgeons of Canada. The expense for this pathway is pretty high and can run up to $7,000 or even more at the time of me recording this. The last pathway for specialists on the Royal College track is called the Subspecialty Examination Affiliate Program, the SEAP. This pathway will get you eligible for a subspecialty certification. The training assessment is applied at this website that you see on the screen and in the description below. If the Royal College grants you eligibility, then the same thing happens. You have 5 years to take the Royal College exam. If you pass the exams, you will receive a Royal College attestation and can join Royal College as a subspecialist affiliate. However, here is the confusing part. To my knowledge, this does not give you a Royal College certification or fellowship. Here is a bonus tip. In addition to province-based pathway and the three different Royal College-based pathway, there is also a fifth program that someone who is very experienced, who is at the level of a professor in India or any other country, can come to Canada and be Royal College certified. Most people, to my knowledge, are not at that stage. But if you're at that stage trying to move to Canada, post in the comments below. I can share more information about that specific pathway where you can directly move to Canada and become a Royal College specialist. A similar program for IMGs exists in the USA where you can be a specialist without a residency, and this is called the Alternate Entry Path Program. And I have left links to the videos on this in the description below, highlighting the steps on how you can get to the USA. Now that you know about USA and Canada, which one should you choose is a critical question if you have a choice. And I have a video specifically for that too. Do check this video out so you make the right choice. Any questions, leave in the comments below. If you found any value with the video, make sure to hit the like button. Take care, stay safe. I will talk to you soon.